Our children are starting to get interested in computers. They like to play a few easy games on our Betasera game PC in the living room, and recently, especially our oldest, likes to do a little drawing on my laptop. Time to get them their own one. In a few years they will probably need to use a Chromebook for school, so I guess it's a good thing if they already know their way around a keyboard and mouse or touchpad. For this, I'm going to install Linux on my wife's old laptop and install some kid-friendly games and applications on it. Come on, I'll show you! I'll boot my Ventoy stick and this time choose Fedora's KDE edition. I just like KDE better than GNOME, and I know Fedora is easy to keep updated, but any distro should do if you'd like to do something similar. I'll enable Wi-Fi first. I'm not sure if the installer will use any online sources, but I know that Fedora copies the network config over to the installed system at least. Run the installer. It has already chosen Dutch for me, probably because of my Dutch IP address. I'll go with that since my kids won't be able to understand English yet. Just clear the whole drive and set up a user account for myself. I'll create a kids account without administrative rights later on. Right, there it goes. And it's done. Let's set up an account for our kids without administrative rights. We don't want them to install or remove anything on their own, right? First thing I'd like to do is to set up some form of parental controls for the browser. For Firefox on Linux, there doesn't seem to be a very trustworthy one though. The top one has only 32 users. So I installed Chromium and removed Firefox. Chromium can use Chrome plugins, since it's basically Chrome. The top one here has 26 reviews and seems to have at least 4,000 users, so let's just use that one. Know that this is not at all a perfect solution. Kids could simply disable the plugin and be done with it. Some sort of access control through a router or proxy would work, I guess, but the one built into our router simply didn't work at all. Anyway, our kids are not going to use this laptop without at least one of their parents being around, so it's not a huge deal at this point. I still have a few years to figure out something better. Right, get some games and educational stuff on this thing. I start with TuxRacer, a cool game I've shown on this channel before. It's a very simple game in which you'll never die, whatever you do, so pretty good for young kids. I'm trying to do it as wrong as I can here. Another game I would like to install is SuperTuxKart. It's a bit harder than TuxRacer, but not that much. This is not the fastest laptop around, so I set the resolution to 720p and the graphical effects level to 2. This makes it run quite well on this laptop, which by the way, only has a Pentium dual core CPU, GeForce 310 mobile graphics and 4 GB of DDR3 RAM. When my daughter tried to play this, she accidentally changed the volume or screen brightness a lot. Not sure who at Samsung thought it was a good idea to put the FN key over here. So I took the key out and removed this rubber thingy to prevent the key from being pressed. There's still an FN key on the other side of the keyboard, so we don't really need this one. Next, I'll install my daughter's favorite, TuxPaint. She likes to play with this on my laptop, which was the main reason for configuring this one for the kids. In TuxPaint you can paint. It's a bit like MS Paint, but with some funny sound effects and stamps and stuff. Recently, I asked you guys what you would install. Laser Sparkle had quite a few ideas for me. The first being TuxTyping. I didn't know this one yet, but it's a fun game, which my daughter very much likes, so thanks for the suggestion. This is obviously an educational game that teaches children how to use a keyboard. For example, in Fish Cascade, there are fish falling from the sky, but they're covered in words you'd have to fully type so Tux can eat them. If you don't, the fish will crash into the ground and you'll lose a life. In Comet Zap, you need to shoot the following words or letters. There's more to it, but this will keep my kids busy for a while. Let's put it in Dutch now. Next is SuperTux, a cool platformer in the spirit of Super Mario. To be honest, this is a bit too hard for young kids, as you can easily die by doing nothing, or not jumping, or jumping wrong. It looks easy for us adults, but it's really not in the hands of a young kid. Very fun game nonetheless, so I'll just leave this on here so they can practice to get good. Another of Laser Sparkle's suggestions was Amelia Pinball. It's a pretty basic pinball game with some different tables to play. I loved pinball games like Pinball Fantasies and Epic Pinball as a kid, so I can see them spending some time on this. The last suggestion was Armagetron, which doesn't seem to be in Fedora's repository. From FlatHub maybe. There it is. This doesn't seem to work very well. I logged in with my own account and used the flat command to install the file. This worked fine. While I'm here, I immediately get rid of the Akinadi suite, since my kids aren't going to use email and calendars and stuff yet. How do you play this game though? What's the goal? Ah well, I'll just leave this on here. Another one of you told me to install GCompris. With that name, I expected a GNOME app, but it's actually a native KDE application. Again, something I had never seen before. GCompris seems to be a comprehensive application, filled with all sorts of learning games. It automatically started in Dutch, which is nice. It does support a wide variety of languages though, as you can see here. Let's see. Ah, match the right tower. Nice. Select the image where the kid is in the box. Select the image where the kid is under the box. Only text on screen though, so this one our children will probably not get until they learn how to read. A sliding puzzle with vehicles. Cool. Jigsaw puzzles are always a favorite. Follow the rhythm. Damn, this is harder than I thought it would be. Maybe that's why I never became a drummer. Playing some notes. Can't start his music lessons soon enough. What do we have more? A maze game.
Goed gedaan.
Memory. What's this? Oh, you'd have to drag the water to the fire. Cool. Well, I think this will keep our children busy for a while. If you have any other suggestions, please leave them in the comments below. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time!